What up, y'all? Phantom Phanatic here. We are here at Six Flags over Georgia, the thrill capital of the South. You can see my mentor and Batman sitting right behind me. It's a little bit busier tonight, so I think we're gonna have to use our disability pass a little more. Maybe not, I don't know. But some cool history about this place. This place opened in 1967, and actually, their opening name roller coaster still operates to this day. The Long Island Mine Train, you're gonna see that here in a bit or so. And you can see my inventor going through the inversions, the classic Schwarzkopf flipping coaster. And there it goes. So that I'm gonna do a shot for y'all. Right. Here goes Batman down its first drop. Trams. All right, let's get inside Six Flags over Georgia. All right, we are here with a very, very special guest. My friend Carson.
What's up?
Yeah, and his family. Right.
Is Haley wearing her shirt?
Right.
That is Georgia. Right. Hey,
hi, Georgia.
You're a star. You're going to be on the TV.
Say hi.
And there's Mama.
Mama
Forrester.
Mama Fanatic.
Oh, we're talking about you. That's golden ticket right there.
Golden ticket. Anyways, we're about to hop on Twisted Cyclone. It's an RMC hybrid conversion of Georgia Cyclone. Do you get to ride the old Georgia Cyclone?
Yeah. Wait, no. I might have. Okay. I think I was here when it was here, but I wasn't tall enough to ride it. So I've seen it, but now it's the Twister.
Yeah.
This ride's
significantly better. You ready?
Yep.
Let's do this. Let's jump. Let's go.
All right, so what do you guys think? You guys want to ride?
Yes, sir.
What's the Cyclone? Any info about the Cyclone here, buddy?
It opened in 2018, and it's an RMC hybrid conversion of Georgia Cyclone. It goes 50 miles an hour, and it's 100 feet tall, and it's the shortest RMC iBox coaster of all of all.
So,
yeah. Yeah.
You've ridden this before, Carson, have you?
I rode this probably five times.
Is it one of their best ones? It's a good coaster.
It's good. I wouldn't say it's the best, but it's one of the good ones. It's one of the better ones.
Yeah, definitely. I wish it ran twice. I don't think it's long enough. It needs to run twice.
It only goes like from there to there and back, so it's not very... It
comes down, comes back, and then comes back in. All right. So,
maybe it's windy.
Get on.
All right, ready to do this?
Let's go. All right, y'all, here we go. We're on Twisted Cyclone with my man, Carson.
Are they recording?
Yeah. You excited, man?
Will we pull these down or will they?
I think we can fly it right. But that Atlanta's roller coaster, RMC, is unreal. Should be going anywhere now, though. Here we go.
Is it tight?
Yeah.
Dude, that thing looks too tight.
No. I still got some room between me and the restraint. Ready?
Sidewalk camera clear. Try to secure our visual scan. It just ain't clear. It's ain't clear. All scenes all clear. All clear. We can just make it ride.
Alright. Here we go. Woo! Push it, cycle. Right, here we go. Here we go. This is this pretty well, Carson.
That's my favorite part!
Whoa!
Whoa!
Oh, yeah.
Are these carts new?
Yeah, I think so. Oh. Going up the big left hill. It's not as fast-paced as Lightning Rod.
What are you most excited to ride?
Yeah.
Are you excited to ride Superman?
Yep. Most excited for
Superman
Goliath.
Superman or Goliath or Mountside?
Goliath.
That was fun, though.
Yeah, that was super fun.
Look at how old it is in there.
Yeah.
Is that when they, like, repair the...
Maybe. I think so. I don't know. I don't work for Six Flags over Georgia.
They have one of those on the Mindbender too. They have, not Mindbender, the DeLonghi Gold Mine. It's like a separate little track.
DeLonghi Mine Train?
Yeah, yeah. I don't know what it's called. It used to be called the DeLonghi Gold Mine.
I did not know that.
I actually went to the DeLonghi Gold Mines 2 weeks ago.
The real one?
Yeah. I went underground into the cave.
Yeah.
It's pretty cool.
Alright, y'all, that was the POV of Twisted Cyclone here at Six Flags over Georgia. We'll see you when we get to our next drive.
Welcome back.
Good stuff. Good stuff. We got off of Twisted Cyclone, what you think?
Okay, so it was a lot better than I remembered it to be. Well, I come maybe three times a year. So last time I came it was with you and Lonnie.
Yeah,
and
for
we
Fright
went
Fest.
On all, yeah, Fright Fest. And since what I remember, it was a lot better than what I remembered. It felt a lot faster. I don't know if that's just me. Or if it is faster, but it felt a ton bit faster.
Yeah. Alright, now we're headed to DC Super Friends to check out the Joker Funhouse. Is it closed? Yeah, the Joker Funhouse coaster. It's a Chance Big Dipper.
Have you rode that one? We rode that one, haven't we?
Oh
my gosh,
yeah.
I love that ride. The one, like, the very end over there.
Pandemonium. Yep.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Pandemonium.
That's a great ride. The Joker Funhouse coaster goes 30 miles an hour. It has a height of, I don't know the height, but nor do I know the length. But it used to be called Wiley Coyote Canyon Blaster. So, yeah. Let's get on.
efforts on testing.
Alright y'all, here we go. We're here on Wonder Moon Flight School, the Flying Scooters ride. Carson, you ready?
Yes, sir.
Let's snap them. Let's snap these cables.
This is going to be a very shoe-buckling experience.
Yeah, we're going to...
That's for kids. It's for babies, like Georgia.
Nah.
I'm just kidding, I love Georgia.
Yeah. Carson.
What?
Out there.
What is it? I couldn't tell.
She was taking a picture. Another one.
So my kid's now about to board. Whoever wants to walk on the Wonder Woman flight scooter, it must be at least 13 inches or high. 48 inches is the tall ride alone. 44 inches is the tall ride alone. Oh my God. Prior to boarding this ride, we don't forget to leave a loose article upon the left. Game hats, phones, coats, bags, and purses. Hats, phones, coats, bags, and purses. Please remain seated at all times while this ride is in motion. Please remain seated at all times while this ride is in motion. Please keep all body parts inside this ride. Entrance gate clear, exit gate clear, options all clear, all clear. This place is your ride.
Alright, y'all, here we go. Wonder Woman Flight School POV. Yeah. Wait till it gets up to its high speed and then we can really mess with this thing. Here we go. Oh.
Turn it.
I'll show you how it's doing, boy. Time to ride.
Welcome back. Hope you enjoyed the ride. Once this ride comes to a full and complete stop, I will be around to unlock all the screens. Once again, I will be around to unlock all the screens. It's just to your left. Please don't forget to grab this Odyssey Stand to the left gate. Thanks for being out at this place over Georgia. Have a safe day.
Woo! Alright, y'all. That was the POV of Wonder Woman Flight School here at Six Flags over in Georgia. We'll see when we get to our next ride. Superman Ultimate Flight. There's Six Flags over Georgia. We're strapped in, we're ready to go. Here we go. Go, Carson. I can't wait for that pretzel loop. That's so intense. I thought I was trying to kill you. Here we go! Yeah. Here we go! No headphones! The terrain looking. advantage. Here we go. We're almost at the top. And here we go. Here we go. Here I am! Oh my gosh! Wow, I actually grayed out on the pressure loop.
So do you actually go upside down on that ride?
Kind of. You go on your back and you experience positive G's. Alright y'all, that was a POV of Superman Ultra Flight here at Six Flags over Georgia. We'll see when we get to our next ride. Alright y'all, here we go. We're on Gray American Screen Machine. Here's Six Flags over Georgia. And here we go! The new Gray American Screen Machine.
Have you rode it new?
Yeah. It's glass move up front. Oh god. That's the old track. This is a new track. Carson, the key is to hold your lap bar up because it can like come down further and stay to you so you won't get as much air time. It's like Blue Hawk down. Front row is the seat. I didn't get as much air time either as like lap last time we rode this, we were like, I was like flying on every hill. This time, not so much.
Do you want to do the Joker coaster?
Sure. We can do it. Blue Hawk's right over there, but I don't know if it's operating.
You
want
to go do Blue Hawk?
Alright, we just came off of the retract Great American Scream Machine. And in my opinion, that was not as quite as good as the first ride. It didn't have as much air time when we were seeing Road 2. And let me take these glasses off real quick. And let me just show you. It's an ace landmark. The American Coaster Enthusiast. This coaster goes 57 miles an hour and has a height of 107 feet tall.
How do you get footage out of them?
And it's about 2,000 feet of track somewhere around there. So yeah, let's get on to our next ride. Alright, we tried to get on Blue Hawk, that was close. Then we tried to get on Pandemonium, that was close. Now we're headed up to Goliath, their B&M Hyper Coaster, Carson's most overrated roller coaster.
It's Blue Hawk. Blue Hawk is the most overrated coaster ever. Blue Hawk is absolutely terrible. I hate Blue Hawk.
I love Goliath.
I love Goliath. Goliath is the best.
I know you said whatever.
Wait, no, Superman's the best. Goliath is second. Blue Hawk is dead last.
Followed by, wait.
Apollo, guy. Thank you.
What's like that middle, ride that's here at the park?
The plantation.
The coaster. Got a lot of hills.
This has been very Chewbacca.
Yeah. You can see Monster Mansion right there running.
Monster Mansion.
Yeah, that's what I thought. It's a dark ride. It's the most popular ride here at the park by far. And we got a big banana. A Mimo big banana. Six below. There's the Raymond Gap train station for the Texas, which is the trainer train.
See Daredevil Dive.
Yeah, there's Daredevil Dive, the 2011 Gerstlauer Eurospider. It actually has lap bars instead of the shoulder strings. It's a lot more comfortable of a Eurofighter than Mystery Mine. You like it better than Mystery Mine, Carson?
What?
Dear Little Dove?
Yeah.
The Eurofighter?
What's Mystery Mine? Oh, wait, no.
The Eurofighter.
The Mystery Mine is much better.
Make your Six Flags memory vivid with Icy.
The Little Dive is more comfortable, don't you think, of an experience?
I feel like Mystery Mine's a little tight. But aren't they supposed to be tight?
Yeah, but the restraints are much different. There's the B&M Hyper Coaster, the best ride here, Goliath. And that's where we're next to 2006 B&M Hyper Coaster.
What is it?
And It's got a really neat layout. It goes outside the park and has a hill that's surrounding one of the, it has some of the best airtime of any B&M hyper, including me and like Orion, Fury 25.
Are we going to Goliath again?
Yeah, I'm back to the, yeah. Goliath. Alright, we're headed up to Goliath and we'll see y'all there.
Alright, y'all, here we go. We're here on the Goliath in the front row.
It's rock.
And we should be going. And here we go. Here we go! Goliath! Front row! Let's go! Alright, so this coaster is up in 2006. It's a B&M hyper coaster, but it barely cracks the 200 foot, but it feels even taller because of the trees. And this thing goes 70 miles an hour and has over 5,000 feet of track.
Here we go. 5,000 feet of track.
I think maybe 4,000, maybe. I don't know. Arms up, Carson. Yes. Yes.
Hands up.
Here we go. Goliath in the front row, and that was really, 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 really good, but it wasn't great. And now we're headed toward Gotham City, and I think we're gonna get a time for Mindbender, then go back to Batman, and then do Mindbender again. So as for Mindbender, that ride opened in 1978, and it's a scorched golf flipping coaster that got renovated this past year. Nope, not this past year, sorry. Like 2021, 2022-ish. It has some good airtime. We're getting on Riddler Mindbender. It's a 1978 classic sports golf flipping coaster. This thing opened in 1978, and
It goes 50 miles an hour. It is about 80 feet tall. It has a length of about 2,000, 3,000 feet of track. So yeah, let's get on.
Alright y'all, here we go. We're here on the Denver Mindbender.
Have you done a video on the Mindbender?
Yeah. This is my second.
To my guest in Q-Line, get off the hair reel. Yeah,
here we go. We're in our Mindbender POV. What'd you think? New
rumor. I thought that was pretty good.
Yeah.
I read that in the book, it's true.
The old one is superior. Roll Tide! Alright y'all, that was a POV of Rumor Mindbender here at Six Flags over Georgia. We'll see when we get to our next drive. Alright y'all, here we go. We're here on Batman the Ride. Here at Six Flags over Georgia. The coaster opened in 1997 and goes 50 miles per hour and it's got a 105-foot height. And I was doing like a 1,000 feet of track. Flipper takeoff, here we go.
This is my kind of coaster.
Do you have a new front row on this?
No.
Here we go! Batman! I'm gonna try the back next time.
Dude, my legs hurt so bad.
Get that butt on front row. Two-way shoot check.
Yes.
Have you ever lost shoes on a ride?
Imagine the back. Alright y'all, that was the POV of Batman the Ride here at Six Flags Over Georgia. We'll see you when we get to our next ride.
This time in here, our call with the cell phone will stop the ride and ask you to leave.
We'll soon we get to our next ride.
Oh, it's right there.
I'm a light scorpion of the music stars. Easy to forget. Oh, no. I think it's time for running the cover.
Alright y'all, here we go. We're here on Daredevil Dive. And we're all clear and out of here. Here we go. Alright, so this is the Dark Smiling Airfire. It opened in 2011. It's 95 feet tall. And it was 52 miles an hour. If it was a Gerstlauer Classic Beyond Vertical Drop at 95 degrees. Here we go. It's about to happen. Here we go. Fucking spray.
ever seen. Alright, we're at the top. Arms up! Here we go! Woo! That was a POV of the Triple D Dare Double Die here at Six Flags Over Georgia. We'll see when we get to our next ride. Alright, we just got off the Dare Double Die of the first 30-mile Euro Fighter. What do you think?
Oh, it was good. It was actually really good.
Super smooth. Alright, we're heading, with that being said, we're heading to another smooth classic. One that I started recently liking, Georgia Scorcher. This is one of those 1999 B&M stand-ups. It's actually B&M's last stand-up ever built by the company.
What was? Georgia Scorcher?
Georgia Scorcher was the last stand-up ever built. Or the latest one built. This one is the smoothest, apparently, and it's also the... Yeah, it's smooth. And it goes 52 miles per hour, and it's 107 feet tall.
You gotta go downstairs,
I think.
Yeah. Is this the exit right here?
Tall.
No.
It's
down farther. You done with that?
And
you done with that?
It's over, like, 2,000 to be a track. So, yeah. Let's get on Georgia Scorcher. Alright. That is going to conclude our day here at Six Flags Over Georgia. We had a very good time today. On all the coasters in the front row. Except for one. Or two. Two. Or three. All but three. And here's Georgia Scorcher. Fly by the realm. Alright, Phantom Phanatic golden ticket. Signing out from the Thrill Capital of the South, Six Flags Over Georgia.
Signing out.
Peace.
From Apollo, golden ticket. Golden ticket. Say peace out.
Peace out. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed this video. And shout out to our man Carson for coming down with us. And if you did enjoy this video, make sure you like this video, share it with your friends, and subscribe to my channel for more. Peace.